Hey, what's up, guys? I just got my oven fixed yesterday after 2 months being broken. I had a cooling fan error or something in my convection oven, and I always thought when you're cooking food in an oven that you want to heat it up, not cool it down. Anyways, my oven was broke down for 2 months, and part just came in yesterday. The guy came in and installed it. Now I got a working oven, and I've been really anxious to use it. I really like using my oven, and I've been using a toaster oven for 2 months, so this is a little refreshing for me. So today I'm gonna make up a focaccia, and tonight I'll probably do some pizza or something like that. So I'm just gonna do a quick little how-to for the focaccia. So I'm gonna start with some garlic. I do have a recipe that I'm using, but it calls for 2 cloves. I'm gonna use 5, so there's the 5 cloves I'm using. Grab my knife, and I'm just gonna smack, oh, this one's already got the skin off, so we'll just. Okay, perfect. There is my chopped garlic. I'm gonna throw 1/2 cup of olive oil into this pan. Throw the garlic in. 2 teaspoons of thyme, throw that in. Then I got 1 tablespoon of rosemary. I'm just going to chop it up a little bit. It's dried. And then I'm gonna stick it on my stove, low heat, for 5-10 minutes. While it's doing that, I got 1 cup of warm water. If you don't have a thermometer like I do, this is a candy thermometer. You want it at about 100 to 110 Fahrenheit. It's actually dropped since I put this in. So basically, just warm. If it's too hot, it's gonna kill your yeast. So you put your finger in it, should feel warm. Let's see where it's at. I bet you it's not 100 yet, but. Okay, so it's just breaking 100 now. I'm just gonna warm up this bowl. This bowl is cold. Okay. Bowl is hot. I'm gonna throw this water in the bowl. And 2 1/4 teaspoons of yeast. Spoons. I'm gonna mix some honey with it. Honey, you can use sugar, just activates the yeast a little better. It's food and makes it bubble and foam and all that jazz. So I'm just gonna take my honey here and just about that much. Yeah, do a little bit more. And then I'm gonna let that sit for 5 minutes or so. Clean off this board. And I'll be right back. Okay, so now I got my garlic and herb infused olive oil. So I'm just going to throw this back into this. So if you remember the yeast that I had going with the honey and the warm water, now it looks, I don't know if you can see that, but it's quite frothy now. So what I'm gonna do is, and I'm just gonna mix it around and let it sort of rest for a bit, soak this flour up with the herb mixture and the yeast. And we're just gonna let it sit for 5 minutes. Because this is my block of Romano here. So I don't know how much I'm gonna use, but let's say cut this much here. This little rind here, you can eat it. Some say You don't eat it. Personally, I just cut them off. And you can throw them into like a soup or something, or pasta sauce, and just cook it with these. And I do have a little stash of old ones. I just keep them in a bag in the fridge. And like I said, make a spaghetti sauce or something, throw a couple of these in it, and they just impart the flavor of the Romano or Parmesan or whatever you want. Put that back there. See if this will fit. It will. There you go. Cheese grated instantly. It's awesome. Love it. And this is sat for 5 minutes, so I'm going to take, I don't know, this much. Quarter cup, half cup, handful. Throw it in there. Mix it up. And the rest I'm going to save for later. I'll throw that on top when I'm done. All right, we're back. The dough has risen for a little over an hour. My phone was busy doing some things, downloading some other videos, and I couldn't start the video. So let's just grab the dough here. And take this, and I'm just gonna pour it all over. A lot of stuff left in the bottom there. Got a little scraper here, spatula if you will, and we're just gonna get all this gunk on here and spread it around, getting in all those holes. This will make that crust really crispy on the top. And there we go. Almost. All right, we're back. 20 minutes has passed. This is ready to go in the oven. 450 for 15 to 20 minutes. I find 15 minutes is never enough. I live at sea level. Ocean's two blocks away from my house, and I'm maybe 10 meters up in elevation, so I'm not sure how the cooking and the barometric pressure work. Welcome back. Timer just went off. Time to pull that focaccia out of the oven. It's been 20 minutes, maybe an extra minute in there. And shut off my oven. Put that 450 degree air out a little bit. There you have the focaccia. I'm just gonna pull it out now. Remember what I was saying about the, it's a lot easier just to pop out. And let's see here, I'm gonna just throw it on a rack. Pull this back in here for now. And pop that out. That's pretty much it. There's a focaccia, and you just watched it start.